super very fast video. It's gonna be replacing like a rubber o-ring to power steering pump. Try to do that before you replace the actual pump, because the o-ring costs like $5, if not less. I'm not gonna show you how to replace the top one. I did it already. It's super simple. You take those two bolts out, take this, replace it. The tough one is right here, and it's under this plastic piece, 10 millimeter bolt. I think you can kind of see there. Very tough to get to it. I tried to use wrench, ratchet, different sizes, nothing worked. So I literally had to order another tool. Hopefully that's gonna work. Like I say, I tried a bunch of different stuff, spent a couple hours and nothing worked. So let's see if the tool I got would actually work. Okay, so that's what I found on Amazon for $6, 10 millimeter. That's the smallest ratchet I have. It's a quarter, I believe. And if you compare this one versus this tool, a lot smaller. So hopefully it's gonna work. I tried this regular 10 millimeter wrench, that didn't work. So let's try this. Actually, it'll be a good idea to put something underneath just in case to catch bolt or o-ring. There we go. And let's see if it's gonna work. I really hope so. So far looks good. I was able to put it on. Now I'll just push it down. Hopefully it's gonna come off. Just put it on the stand. I don't know how much you'll be able to see, but hopefully something. Even with this tool, it's not too easy. It's actually worked. So you just need to put a little bit of pressure. I mean, you have to loosen it up just a bit, and then you'll be able to just remove it with your fingers. But you definitely, I definitely needed that tool. I tried with regular wrench and with ratchet, didn't work at all. Maybe, potentially, if I spent another hour or two, maybe I would be able to take it off. Maybe, but for $6, I'd rather do this. There you go. You know what's crazy is, at least on this side, I don't even see. I don't even see o-ring. Oh, okay, there it's inside. Make sure you have, probably good idea to have pick tool, I think that's how it's called. The brand I'm using is Channel Lock. I had them for a couple years at least, and they've always been very reliable. So with this, I'll take out the o-ring. Try to take it out. It's stuck there pretty good, there you go. Definitely been very used. here is replacement. It's interesting that the replacement is red and the original one was black. I don't know if it was recalling the replaced the O-ring or not, but this is what it is. So I'm gonna just wipe it, clean that place just a little bit. I don't know how important it is, but I'll still clean it. Looks pretty good. Now I'm gonna actually also wipe this one off too. Time to put the red one on. So now everything's in reverse order pretty much. You're gonna put this bolt first. I'm gonna hand tight it as much as I can. It's going pretty good. Now just I'm gonna use this just for tiny bit, not much though, just put a little bit pressure there. Okay. And let's start the truck. Gonna open this one to let air out. Wouldn't hurt to turn the steering wheel each side. Got 246,000 miles. No idea if pump or ring been replaced ever before. Probably not. I think it's already, yeah, sounds good. I don't hear any issues now. So that's it, that's how you replace the O-ring. If you want me to include a link, if you want me to include the link to the tool from Amazon, let me know and I'll put it on YouTube. But that's how it looks. 10 millimeter. Without that tool, I don't know how long it would have taken me to replace it. So it's a, in my opinion, it's pretty much a must-have or something like that. If you can get something with that small clearance, that should do it. If you have any questions, post it on YouTube. And I'll try to respond as soon as possible. But that's it.